the show the drift. Tune in every Sunday this summer from 4:30 to 5:30 p.m. to enjoy this weekly Sherman Griffin promotional event, bringing you the best music, comedy, and poetry in Milwaukee. Here's your host, Heinzel Kunzel.
again, all these donations would go just towards these promotional events that we're doing during the summer. We are in contact with foundations and other organizations to receive grant money when our project is shovel ready. So we have a very exciting performance here for you today. I was fortunate enough to have the opportunity to perform with this group in December when we did the Flamenco Nutcracker. We have Kerensa DeMars, who will be dancing for you, and Marija Temo, who is, I think I'm blocking them. Oh, no, they were, you're just in the shade. And Marija Temo will be on flamenco guitar. This will be some very exciting exciting performance for you. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. was really, really great. I already knew it was going to be really exciting like this. Are you out of breath?
I'm okay.
Okay. I spoke last time with Maria when she was here last year. So I can maybe speak a little bit more with you. Can you first give us your background, like in terms of what first got you started with dance, flamenco dance?
That was it. I was like mesmerized and blown away by the music and the dance and everything about it. And I took some classes in the Bay Area, and then I moved to Spain and studied there and lived there for about 10 years, where I apprenticed with master artists. And then I came back to the States and started working here and in San Francisco, and moved back to Wisconsin, which is my home state, about 3 years ago.
Great. And so, and when you moved back, you formed Studio K?
Studio K Flamenco, and we've been doing ongoing classes for all ages, youth, adults, seniors. We do programs in Milwaukee Public Schools. We have the annual production of the Flamenco Nutcracker, which Maria is the musical director, and you were part of the show last year. It was so great. And we also do other performances around the area.
In classes for people of all ages on instruments and instruments on guitar too, or mostly dance?
Guitar.
That's great. So what are some challenges in getting really young kids to get their feet wet with flamenco?
None. You know, it's funny. I've been teaching kids for a long time, from 3 and 4 years old to teenagers. And I think kids really connect with the rhythmic aspects of flamenco. And, you know, it's a very different dance style than what sometimes kids are used to. It's more of a street dance form than ballet or something like that. It's very informal. It's a cultural art form. So it's all about your personal style, body percussion, listening to the music, responding to the rhythm. And I think, in my experience, kids of all ages, boys and girls, connect with that really quickly.
Yeah, that was something that was very striking to me, is that flamenco dancers, I mean, their body is basically an instrument where they're feeling, it's a very percussive instrument where you're feeling lots of different types of rhythms. But then also the costumes, the design, the dresses and the shoes are also a really big part of it. And I know you design all your own dresses. Did you design this one?
I did, actually. A good friend of mine made it, and I, you know, it's been really fun. I really like this one. You're right, we think of ourselves as musicians, you know, not only percussively with the footwork, but also how we phrase our choreography with the music, the kante, the singing, and the guitar. To me, every time I start working on choreography, I start with the music in mind. I never dance independently of the music. It's always first for me.
Okay, and so how about some other percussive instruments that are related to flamenco, like the castanets?
The castanets. More recently, the cajon was introduced. It's a box that you sit on. It's actually a Peruvian instrument, but it was brought into flamenco. And so those are some of the things that you might see featured. And there's other instruments that have become more popular in flamenco besides guitar, like piano, flute, sax, bass, even drum sets. So,
So here's a question I've wondered: how has so it's an art form that's from Spain originally? Has it had any influence on Latin America, South America, or Central America?
I would say that almost the reverse. Latin American music has influenced flamenco more than the reverse. I think that, you know, we can go way back and see how Spanish cultural traditions influenced Latin America, but there's a pretty heavy Latin American influence in flamenco. It's a very vibrant art form that's always evolving, much like jazz. You know, there's lots of people are adding new ideas to it. It's not a static cultural tradition, so artists, whether musicians or dancers, are really encouraged to develop their own style, their own vocabulary, and now you see all kinds of cross-disciplinary collaborations from Spain to Cuba, and, you know, with rock and roll, and with jazz, and there's all kinds of doors opening. So flamenco is very much traditional element, but there's also a very strong contemporary element.
So how about the influence of flamenco in Milwaukee here? It seems like you and Maria are the core. Is that fair to say? Okay, and so we've plugged your studio case. So if people want to learn more about flamenco, obviously your website would be the place to go, and to as well as your studio in person. They can also learn more by going to some of your performances, and you have one coming up next Friday.
Okay,
so great.
All Friday nights, all at Sunstone Studios, it will be Maria and I, and it's a really good time. You can come down, have a drink. Kids are welcome.
Great. All right, Maria has a mic on, so I don't have to like invite her over here. You told me this story last time about how you became interested in flamenco from when you were very little and where you're from. I mean, your name, everything about you, if you hadn't told me this story, I would have thought you were from Mexico or so, like Brazil or somewhere, you know, but maybe you could tell your story how you got involved. Of Katy and I, Ohio, right?
Ohio.
Or Akron, Ohio. Okay.
And so they met at the bus stop where we went to go to school.
Oh, okay.
And I couldn't wait to go to class and learn all the hand claps and the dances. And then just one thing led to another. She was somehow able to find a guitarist who was 2 hours south in Columbus who drove up for class. And I think that was literally the change. I really loved dance. There's no question, but that was a stronger pull for sure. I couldn't get my eyes off him. I couldn't wait. He was the strumming, the lasciados.
And you have a very beautiful voice, and you're originally an opera singer, is that right?
You mean trained? Well, I went to the conservatory. I minored in voice.
Voice, okay.
I learned opera studies, but I minored in vocal techniques there. But I've been singing as a kid in choirs and so forth, all that, and I taught myself how to sing flamenco.
So what are some characteristics of voice in flamenco music?
It's actually what I think of it as expressing the pain that associates with the whole culture of the flamencos and gypsies that travel, that they express all their emotions through their music.
Okay.
So I think rather than an opera when you sing something tragic, it's gorgeous sounding.
Mm-hmm.
Right? You hear this element of pain through the voice and everything in flamenco is how I kind of feel it. So there's always some element of heaviness to even the light numbers.
Okay. and that ties directly into the concept that it's a street art form that you were referring to earlier. Yeah. That's very interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Well, thank you so much for doing this. This is really exciting to have you here in their backyard doing this performance. So you're going to do some more? It's a small world, the flamenco world. All right, let's keep going with the performance.
thank you very much to Marija Temo and Kerensa DeMars from Studio K. So, one more round of applause. And also special thanks to Rebecca Wendt and Aaron Crook, who are doing the sound and video tech here. And we got Jim on the grill back here. And we got a great live audience here. Thanks, Carol, for coming. Hannah, I just met tonight. We got Tony and Bernal in the back. Some new guests I'm going to get to know here in a little bit. My own kids and Jody all watching on. So come join us in person next week when we have Mike Neumeier on vibraphone. And we start at 4:30 and go until 5:30. You're welcome to come here in person, and we'll share the link.